What was your first learning method?
Holy cow! sure you have your button on.
I think that's one of my grand options. You know,
$1. You'll get it back one day. It's for a good cause. Come on, people. It took.
Gosh. Do you want information about us?
There you go.
It was founded in 1986 in Washington, D.C. We are here today at Baltimore Pride to open a Baltimore colony. And we per se do not draw on one university, but we'll draw on the regional universities in the area. That's it.
It meets once a month, every third Monday. And the idea is exchanging information on people who are gay professionals, you know, about issues, gay laws and so on, I mean, anti-gay discrimination, et cetera, et cetera. So that, you know, we're just constantly exchanging information, setting up a support network, that kind of thing.
We do the lobbying in Annapolis during the General Assembly on HIV issues, and we send out weekly alerts to all of our members so they can make sure to call their legislators and keep them honest in Annapolis. Through January through April is the legislative session. So we're asking people to sign up to make sure that we can get them on the mailing list. Would you like to sign up?
I'm supposed to work.
Okay, then I can kind of explain because it's AOC.
Baltimore City.
time. It's like it's the one day out the year we get to come out and be able to do what we want to do, ourselves the way we want to express ourselves. That's where I did, you know.
Basic human rights as everybody else. We live our lives and we pay taxes, we support our government, we do everything. We vote, we listen to people, we're good people. A lot of people give us bad press. There's a lot of decadence in our society, and it's not all from the homosexual group. We just can't celebrate our lives every day like heterosexuals can. We have to pick a day a year. And there's a lot of less than decency things happening that I don't appreciate, but I can kind of understand how people want to be in your face because, it's a big issue and there's a lot of controversy, but basically most of us just want to live our lives. That's all, you know.
I didn't do it. I'm innocent of all charges. Please believe me. Call my lawyer, 976 something.
Created my own company, and in lieu of all of that, we got a grant from Ryan White for the City of Baltimore Health Department, and that has allowed me, I'm a person living with AIDS, and that has allowed me to do some outreach to the black community. And that's it in a nutshell. But we are trying to get community support, and the t-shirt and the book are just one way in which to raise funds to try to further our cause. And as I said, I did get my funding to the health department as an individual, not an organization, and we create this organization. And we are thankful to the City of Baltimore for giving us a start to do community-based organization work. And my end of it is creative. I'm looking for creative HIV people who, like myself, can use their talents and abilities in order to live longer, to enhance their lives, to be productive, even under these circumstances of living with HIV disease.
Also, the quilt, first and foremost, it heals. When someone dies that you know, and you have a lot of pain inside of you, this is one way to relieve some of the pain and some of the suffering by making a quilt for the one you love. And that's what the Names Project's all about.
Don't you feel like no love will turn that mind? Have you will turn that mind?
Yeah. Unique individual in our community. He is singing live today for you. He is the reigning Mr. Gay Baltimore on his way to Mr. Gay Maryland. Please welcome the talents of Mr.